This is how you can create a simple anime workflow in Clip Studio Paint. Starting off, I have the animation timeline at the bottom. You can create a new timeline by clicking this button here. If you don't see the timeline window, go up to the top, click Window, and then go down to Timeline and make sure that's checked. For the background image, it's literally just a random anime PNG file that I found online. If you just Google animation templates or anime templates, you'll find stuff like this. Typically, you'll want to draw within this 1920 by 1080 box in the middle. This box is what the camera sees, and all you have to do is crop into this box in editing. This part is optional, but I like having my own little watermark in the top left corner. This is the layer structure of my animations. I have this animation folder, which in this case is labeled A, and within that is a folder with three layers: line art layer, color layer, and color lines layer. Now, this is optional. This is just for the anime production pipeline, where you draw the red and blue lines to indicate highlights and shadows. You can fill this folder in with whatever folder structure you like, and when you create a new cell, it duplicates whatever you had previously. This way you can mix and match what you want, and it'll be all contained within this folder, labeled 1, 2, and so on. Now, this animation folder is going to be placed inside another folder, which I've labeled animation. Let's look at this example of another animation file that I've already completed. As you can see, I have a bunch of different folders, and within each folder is its own animation cell and all of the frames. The reason that I have everything separated into its own folder in Clip Studio Paint is so that when I export it, it creates its own folder in the export. So you can see under First Key, I have this rough draft. Under Coloring, I have the colored version. Export, I have the composited version. And so if you want to do like works in progress or compare and contrast beginning to end or just using production material on its own, you can definitely use this method to separate all the different production material. You can break this down even further by having multiple animation cells within one folder. So for instance, under this layer, this animator separated things into A, AX, and B, and each of it is its own set of frames. Or you can go further out and separate it based off of the different stages of the animation pipeline. So background, storyboard, layout, and so on. And that's basically how we have our animation files set up for my studio.